So what I'm doing here is I am extracting pet urine in a little bit more of an extreme way here. Rather than just using the carpet wand, I am using what is called a subsurface tool. So this tool allows me to pull moisture from beneath the carpet, allowing me to get more out than typically that you would be able to do with just a carpet wand. So I had saturated these areas in here with a pet treatment product to help break down the urine molecules. And then here what I'm doing now is I am extracting it out after I use some fresh water to rinse it. So I let that happen for a little bit longer. And then move to the next spot. Turn this on. Allow some water through. You can see. Usually for about 3 to 5 seconds at most. And extract it all out. So you can tell that there wasn't much right here. It's not really yellow, but it smelled the worst in these areas. So after I put fresh water down, I let the vacuum part do its thing for a little bit. And if there's an area that you see yellowing come through, you just repeat the process, usually 2 times, 3 times, depending on how excessive it is in that spot, until you get no more yellow coming through. And that's pretty much what you could do if, you know, the client doesn't want to pull the carpet back, they just want to try and do their best to get everything out from the top. So this is a tool that you can use to do so. I've had to use it for other reasons. Mainly it's been used for floods too, small floods. Like if you get a water line break and it soaked the entryway of a carpet, you can use this to extract the water out a little more heavily than what a typical lightweight carpet wand would do. So that's why I wanted to do this in these areas, because it's a bit more thorough than just doing the wand itself. So, like I said, I sprayed these pretty well about a little over a half hour ago. See, there's some yellow I saw come through. So this is a spot right here, more towards the wall, that got hit. So I do this, and because I saw some yellowing come through, I'm gonna try one more time of soaking it to flush it, and then go back and see, there's a little bit more that popped through. So that's why sometimes you gotta repeat the process in certain areas in order to get it out as much as possible here. That way you can salvage the carpet.
Doors aren't exactly on the
on there very well, so they're kind of hard to move. Check this one to see if... Yeah. The tracks on them are pretty old, so these don't move too well. Carpet looks next to new in these closets as well. Still got stuff in. Some cleaning supplies. Guys, I'm gonna keep this going. Alright guys, third job of the day. Two empty houses today. Back to back. So that was awesome. And then the first one, which I don't think I even got any footage besides the pet urine subsurface floor tool. That one was getting sold, but still had some stuff in it. Got a pretty wide open floor plan. So this carpet is only a year old. They just bought the place. It's not in bad condition at all, as you can probably tell. Just wanted to get it cleaned so I have a clean slate for moving into the new home, basically. But otherwise, it is not in bad shape. There's no stains, hardly anything. We vacuumed everything and almost next to nothing came out. So I think the person who they bought the house from left it pretty well kept. And the new homeowner said that they thought that the carpet was about a year old, so that's just going off of what I was told from them. So this carpet does not need a whole lot of effort. Nothing that has been coming through the sight glass that's noticeable. How about them triangles?